Hey, how's it going? My name's Alex, and today we are busting myths about electric over hydraulic brakes. Now, just in case this is your first video stopping by, I am a hotshot transporter, or I have a hotshot transport company. I have 5 company trailers. They all have drum brakes. And I've documented in other videos some of the maintenance issues and some of the challenges I have with those drum brakes. So in a recent video, I got a whole flood of comments saying, Alex, you should switch to electric over hydraulic. Alex, you would never have these problems if you switched to electric over hydraulic, okay? So I wanna give you guys some actual real world experience of electric over hydraulics on a gooseneck trailer. And I had an old trailer that I converted from drum to electric over hydraulic. The calipers were a Kodiak 250 caliper, which I believe is good for 7,000 and 8,000 pound brakes. And I had the good signature, the nice pump, which was way overkill for that type of trailer, that setup. So I know it was a really good kit, but that is the first issue right there. I have real world experience on the ground actually doing it and using it with that system, whereas a lot of people in the comments have no clue. You guys, maybe some of you guys are that are commenting that maybe just read a press release, maybe you listened to the salesman at the dealership, which I don't recall that ever being a good idea, and you know, because they just want to upsell you on a couple of things, and or you watched an advertisement or something, I don't know. Long story short is I have actual experience, you guys have theoretical knowledge. So first small issue with electric over hydraulic is that there is a delay, and the delay is actually a little bit bigger than with electric brakes, right? Electric brakes, it's all a simple system. It plugs into your trailer in your trailer connector in your truck, right? And it sends power right to the brakes, right? And power, what's quicker to send, electricity or actual fluid, right? Because think about it, now you have to run fluid from the pump, which is usually at the front of your trailer, all the way to the back of your trailer. Now, yes, those lines are generally supposed to stay full. However, sometimes they don't. And so what ends up happening is when you squeeze your brakes or when you slam on the brakes, first thing you feel is your trailer kicks you in the back, right? Because the brakes aren't enabled yet. And if you're in an emergency situation, slamming your brakes, you slam with your truck, and then 5 seconds later, your brakes grab and lock up. And because the trailer doesn't have ABS, they lock up and drag, and you're smoking your tires. So there is a small delay with electric over hydraulic because the fluid, it's not a high pressure system where it keeps it extremely pressurized. It's a very low pressure system. So very rarely do you have fluid all the way throughout the whole lines where you do have instant braking. Doesn't happen with electric over hydraulic. So keep in mind, you do have a delay, and that is scary. All right, next issue is the pads. Now, yes, the pads were available basically at any NAPA or AutoZone, but the problem there is it would literally just come out sometimes. I have no idea why. Maybe it's a design defect or something. Maybe it's something they didn't put in consideration. I don't know. But long story short is when the pad comes out of your caliper, what do you got then rubbing on your trailer or trailer brake rotor? The caliper itself. And so that then ruins the cylinder on the caliper or the front side of the caliper where the brake pad usually rests. And so now you're damaging calipers really quickly just because for some reason they couldn't mount it, the pad, in a way where it wouldn't just slide it out. So I had that problem consistently in my caliper disc brake conversion. Next issue, and this is a big one, pay attention because this is important. If you're even remotely considering electric over hydraulic, this is your warning. When your pad flies out, what happens is that cylinder has a rubber seal on it. Sometimes that cylinder can get cut and it leaks out all your fluid. Or the other thing that can happen that can cause the leak all the fluid out is when the hose that connects to the caliper, sometimes it's at first it might be a hard hose and then it's a rubber hose, right? Because that's where your suspension is. So the hose needs to be able to flex. Well, that rubber hose, whether you hit some debris or it's old and it got rotted out, or you know, just whatever the issue is, for some reason, if you lose fluid, keep in mind that doesn't shut off that caliper in any way, shape, or form. That caliper cannot get shut off. And what ends up happening is over the course of braking for the next 30 minutes, all of your fluid gets pumped out of that, like wherever the leak is. And then you lose brakes everywhere. So none of your brakes work. And that does not happen on electric brakes. And it's like when, and it will happen. The time will come that you will lose fluid. You will. And when that happens, you will be stuck with no brakes. And what if you're loaded? Okay. On electric, what happens is if you run over some debris or for some reason the magnet doesn't work in your electric brakes, you just lose that one brake. The other three work just fine. And so because each of these brakes are isolated, you never lose all of your brakes. And the scary part about hotshot and how it's totally different than semi is on semi, when you have air brakes, if you lose air pressure, the air pressure is designed to keep your brakes from slowing you down. So the moment you lose pressure, they actually expand and lock up. And it's not like that on hotshot. If you lose brakes, they don't automatically lock up. They just don't brake anymore. So it is absolutely terrifying to lose all of your fluid and then be stuck trying to find some kind of brake hose or trying to find a caliper if that's what happened or that's where the leak was. Then you're laying on the ground diagnosing where's the leak, and not to mention leaks can be flammable. So depending on if the spark situation, you know, like it's just an absolute nightmare when your trailer leaks and you have no brakes. It is absolutely terrifying, and that will happen with electric over hydraulic. And that leads right into, it's harder to find parts for these brakes. I don't want to say nobody, but very rarely will you find rotors in stock, calipers in stock. God forbid you actually lose your actual pump, which I realize it's rare, but still you could lose your pump, because I had an owner operator that started for me a couple weeks ago. He had electric over hydraulic brakes, and I was kind of like, nah, I mean, whatever, you know, it's your choice. You're an owner operator, you're maintaining it. But when we checked his brake, his pump for some reason failed. And what did he do? His trailer is 3 days old. He literally picked it up at the dealership earlier that week and he did not have brakes. And what did it come out to be? The pump. And they had to replace a pump on a trailer that was 3 days old. That is ridiculous. Luckily, the trailer dealer had one pump available, just one. And at first he was trying to do it through a warranty claim, because obviously it's covered under warranty, and he was trying to do it through a warranty, but they said that would take 2 weeks to process. And then so he had to buy it out of pocket, and then he was gonna wait like on the backside for them to return it. And I actually should follow up with him. I don't know if they actually returned it to him or not, but still, I'm pretty sure they did. But still, the point remains the same, that if you don't get super lucky, they had one pump in stock, one pump. We don't know about calipers, we don't know about rotors, we don't know about any of those other parts, or rubber hoses, guys. Those rubber hoses that connect to the caliper, they rip, and they rip a lot, because your suspension is doing a lot of work. And when those rip, good luck finding hosing for, good luck trying to find a hose for brake fluid that you can then attach all those connections. It is an absolute nightmare trying to find parts. And the last and final issue, guys, like I said in the beginning, I'm up to 5 trailers now, okay? The conversion kit, when I bought it a couple years ago for that trailer, was like $1,200, not including labor. It's like, so let's assume with some labor, let's assume with some other minor little things, I gotta spend $2,000 on each conversion. It's like, I have 5 trailers right now. You guys in the comments are telling me to spend $10,000 to re-switch over the entire fleet to brakes that I know are inferior and are harder to find parts. That's what your suggestion is. Throw away $10,000 on terrible product. It's like, absolutely not. So the cost is ridiculous. I will not be transitioning the whole fleet to electric over hydraulic. And if you're saying, oh, I'll just do one trailer. Well, now I have to train my maintenance guy on how to diagnose electric over hydraulic and electric. So it's like especially when you're dealing with fleet stuff, like when you have multiple trailers, you have to standardize, and I'm not about to switch the entire standardization. So I'm really happy with the electric brakes, the electric 8,000 pound standard brakes that come on all my big tech trailers. I'm very pumped with them. I realize they have a little bit of maintenance, but I would rather deal with that than deal with the problems that I know can happen on the road with electric over hydraulic. Don't forget, check out some of the great channel sponsors in the description down below. I look forward to hearing from some of you in the comments about electric over hydraulic. What has your experience been? Have you had any of these issues that I've mentioned? And I will see you in the next video. Bye.